All right, what's going on, you guys? Nick here with Nick Strength and Power. I've got a couple of interesting stories for you guys today. The first story in this video is a banger of a story, probably my favorite story I've talked about all year. In a photo shoot after the 2020 Mr. Olympia, we got the rare opportunity, thanks to manager Matt, by the way. He posted this on his Instagram, my buddy Matt, with the fire clips. Big Rami posing down with your classic physique Olympia champion, Chris Bumstead. Now, in this video that Matt posted, they just kind of briefly hit a most muscular pose head-to-head. And this is something, you know, people have said for a while, and I agree with this, that at the finals, they should have, just for fun, not for any points or any awards or anything, but they should have the winners of each Mr. Olympia category, 212, Classic, Men's Open, even Men's Physique, if you want to put that in there. They should all just have, like, one pose down just for the entertainment of the crowd. Just run them through a couple mandatory poses or just let them do a freestyle pose down against each other just for fun. I think everybody would love to see Big Rami, Chris Bumstead, Sean Clarita, even Brandon Hendrickson from Men's Physique, just do a pose down at the end of the show, all the champions, because they all have such different physiques, and maybe do like a, maybe make that the People's Champion Award, who's the best of all the winners in the fans' eyes. Actually, comment that in the comment section below. Out of all the categories, who's your favorite Mr. Olympia champion in 2020? Was it the classic physique Chris Bumstead? Was it the men's open bodybuilding giant Big Rami? Was it your 212 giant slayer, Sean Clarita? Or was it your men's physique champion, Brandon Hendrickson? Now, Ian Vieira also posted on his story a picture of Chris hitting your insert favorite classic pose here, and then Big Rami hitting a most muscular, which I think was a pretty fitting picture, because Rami is the mass monster and Chris, of course, is the classic guy. But I can't get enough of this comparison. I love to see something like this, and this, I think, is going to turn out to be a cool photo shoot. And then Matt also had this shot. You guys can judge in the comment section down below. Both hitting a front double bicep, Big Rami and Chris Bumstead. Chris, obviously, with his trademark vacuum pose during the front double. The strong point for Chris is his V-taper. Crazy lat flare from the front, crazy small waist, the vacuum pose really makes this pose look nice for Chris. Obviously, he's a little bit tighter conditioned than Rami at this point, and Rami's strong point in the front double bicep is his overwhelming size, particularly in his arms. I mean, Rami's arms look insane, even next to Chris's in this pose. So just for fun, in the comment section, score this pose. Who's taking it? Chris Bumstead or Big Rami? You love to see it. And also, thumbs up this video if this is something you want to see on the actual Olympia stage, a pose down between these different categories. Now, next up in the news, let's step away from men's physique for a second here and talk about something we haven't talked about in a while on this channel, but something all of you guys enjoy, the strict curl. So this weekend was the strict curl world championships over in the WRP Powerlifting Federation. So this past weekend, the same day as the Olympia, there was the biggest strict curl competition in the world in an attempt to break the strict curl world record. In fact, this was the same organization that Denis Aplinkov originally set that strict curl record in. Now, in this competition, the record was not broken, but the second heaviest strict curl in history was set at this powerlifting meet. And the record was very, very close. You guys might know him as Neezy333 on Instagram or Nazimi Tagiev, a strict curl powerlifting athlete from Moscow, successfully completed the second heaviest strict curl of all time, 109 kgs on his fourth attempt, which is 240.3 pounds, just 9 pounds shy of Denis Aplinkov's world record of 249 or 113 kgs. So this is the closest that anybody has came in an official competition to Denis Aplinkov's record. With the year wrapping up, 2020 is almost over. I don't think the record will fall this year, but I think it will fall very, very soon, because at the time that Denis broke that record or set that record, that was one of those records where people thought nobody is ever going to come close to this because Denis was such a freak. But people are now within 3 kilograms of the record. So you guys thought we forgot just because it's the Olympia weekend, but there was major strict curl There's major Strict Curl news happening this weekend. We had to cover it, so I hope you guys enjoyed that as well. Now, also in the news today, I wanted to mention that Rami made history this weekend, not only by winning the Mr. Olympia this year, defeating Brandon Curry, defeating Phil Heath, but Rami also became the first athlete in Mr. Olympia history to not only win the People's Champion Award, that belt that you can see wrapped around the Sandow, and also win the overall title. So even though this award has only been happening for 3 years, Rolly Winkler was the first recipient back in 2018. In 2019, Heidi Chupin was the second recipient with his third place placing at that Olympia. But Rami is the first athlete in history, again, even though it's 3 years, to receive both the Sandow and the People's Champion Award. And I think Rami definitely deserves a big shout out for recognition of this legendary thing that he's accomplished. He was really against all odds this year. The fact that he came down with the virus, the fact that he couldn't compete to qualify for the Olympia. He tried to go to the Arnold Classic Australia. He couldn't because of the lockdown there. He tried to compete in the Europa Spain. He couldn't because he tested positive for the coronavirus. He tried his best to get to the Olympia. He had to go there off of a special invitation. A lot of other bodybuilders, other athletes, fans were saying Rami shouldn't even be there because he didn't qualify like everybody else. He proved everybody wrong because he beat every bodybuilder in that lineup, despite the fact that he got there off a special invitation. That kind of proves the merit of the special invitation system. Bodybuilders that deserve to be there should be invited because those bodybuilders can turn out to be the bodybuilders that win the whole show, like in Big Rami's case. So shout out to Big Rami. He made history this weekend, and I think we're going to see great things from him in the future, and I think the bar has just been raised for the standard at the Mr. Olympia in terms of conditioning and also sheer size. So congratulations again to your 2020 reigning Mr. Olympia, Big Rami. Now, the final story that I want to talk about in this video is a scene from the Olympia that's been going viral. This clip of Heidi Chupin versus Phil Heath. Now, this was an interesting one because Heidi wants to stand with Phil and get those comparisons from the front. Heidi Chupin and Phil Heath was one of the most debated placings at the Olympia. Phil Heath taking third place, Heidi Chupin taking that fourth place spot. A lot of people felt at finals especially that Heidi should have placed over Phil because he was sharper. And the judges actually had Heidi ahead of Phil. They had Heidi in second in their final scores, but not in the prejudging scores. That's why Heidi ended up in fourth. But this clip of Heidi and Phil, Heidi calls out Phil, and Phil says, okay, but let's turn around and hit a back shot. Heidi pulls him and makes him hit a front shot against him, and then Phil kind of walks away. Some would say walks away very quickly. There's a little pep in his step to get away from Heidi. So this clip was interesting because of the fact that A, Heidi was very aggressive, and B, this clip was taken at finals. And the reason why that is noteworthy is because at prejudging was where Heidi was deliberately staring at Phil's midsection. Heidi made a point. This clip was going viral as well on Reddit. Heidi made a specific point to stop and stare at Phil's midsection during the prejudging routine. And Phil kind of looked visibly uncomfortable, acting like he couldn't see it. But I think that made it even more noteworthy that in this video that's going viral now, Heidi was trying to turn Phil around and make sure he showed from the front against Heidi. And I thought this clip was a great clip. And one of the reasons I like Heidi, because he wasn't necessarily disrespectful, but he brings that competitive element. If you watched him during the entire finals in this pose down, Heidi was aggressive, but he was playful. He was pulling guys closer to him. He was, you know, like rubbing up against guys with his most muscular. He was just making it exciting to watch. And that's why I like Heidi, because not only does he bring an impressive package to the Olympia stage, but he's fun with it. He's like, he has a good time with it. He makes people want to watch him on stage. He's not just this boring guy that walks around, you know, frowning. He's fun. But let me know what you guys think in the comment section down below. Again, I hope you guys have enjoyed all the Olympia coverage. 3, 4, 5 videos a day. But I'm having fun making them because you guys are having fun watching them. So if you are enjoying the videos, make sure you leave a like. Make sure you subscribe to the channel. As always, I love you guys. I appreciate you guys. Nick Strength and Power, signing out.